Hello everyone, now we will talk about more important questions on to the Redux which you might face on to the React Redux interview. So what is a pure function? So this is actually not about the Redux. Pure functions are the concept of JavaScript. It's just a pure functions which are asynchronous, which doesn't deal with the IO or the any kind of database data and all. They will always pass the processing, because in the pure functions you will be doing asynchronous operations and you know what result you are going to get. So consider addition functions where you are passing the value of A and B and returning C, which is equal to A plus B. So you always know that when you are passing A equal to 1 and B equal to 2, you always get C equal to 2. So these are the predictable functions and pure functions which doesn't deal with any uncertainty about reading the file, reading the data from the disk, or reading the data from some API. These are the pure asynchronous functions which always pass, which do the pure functional, I mean the pure calculation, where you predict, you can predict that what can be the output. So similarly, the pure functions are the concept of the Redux reducers. In the Redux reducers, those all are pure functions where based on the state they can predict what will be the next state you are going to get. Okay, what is the reducers in the Redux? So I have covered that in the previous questions. Reducers are the pure JavaScript functions, and based on the actions which you are passing, the reducers will decide, is going to decide the next state of your Redux. Because if you are sending the login with the payload, then your Redux next state will be the login data will be there and is logged in will be true. That will be your state. Similarly, your state will be incremental and will keep changing. And it's not changing, it's not updating, it's existing, it is actually always going to create a new state object. So how reducers manage the state of the React app? That is again a good question. So in reducers, what you are doing, you are actually doing a switch case or some kind of a switch code where you are checking off a, okay, the action is A, then my state will be A++, like in the action is increment and your initial state is 0, so your next state will be 1. Now action is decrement, which is decreasing your state equal to with minus 1, then your state will become 0. So similarly, based on your action, your reducer will keep giving you new state object from the reducers. And there can be a multiple reducer in Redux. So flow about Redux is simple, that you have the actions, then reducers, then store, and then your component. Okay, so the flow is very basic, where we just have actions. Actions will trigger the actions and it will go to the reducer. Reducer will calculate the new state and will pass that to the store. Store is a big object which will maintain the complete state tree, and from the view from the React component using React Redux library, which is a connect library, with the help of React Redux connect library, which is acting as a bridge between React and Redux, we will fire the map state to the props and map dispatch to the props to talk to the Redux layer and get the state object or update the state object there. Okay, so what is a time travel debugging? So Redux is providing the Redux dev tool which you can install from the Chrome browser. With the help of Redux dev tool, in the store you need to enable the dev tool extension. After that, you can trace, you can track whatever you are doing. You can track the state based on the actions you are performing. I have already covered the React Redux in depth in my another playlist. If you wanted to have a look how the Redux time travel happens, how this complete flow works, then React Redux is another separate in-depth playlist. You can take a look, or there is a workshop also. So Redux is asynchronous. Sorry, Redux is synchronous. It doesn't understand how the asynchronous flow works. So if we are triggering any action of the API call, the Redux doesn't understand that API call. In that case, we need to put some middleware between your action and reducer. Because reducers are pure JavaScript functions, they need the data. They will not wait for the data coming from some API. So you need to put the Redux middleware between your actions and reducers. So you always supply the data what reducers is needed. So whenever the call is going from the actions to the reducer, we are placing the middleware. Middleware is stopping that flow. It is firing the API call. Once the data is resolved, then only it is passing the data to the reducer. So there are the different middleware. Redux Thunk is there, Redux Saga is there. So these are just different ways to manage the API call and get the data from there. So React Redux library you can use, you can use a Radium library. So there are different libraries using which you can write Redux forms, or you can write a plain HTML and just do all different kind of validations. But we don't have like forms library like Angular is providing, Angular forms, Angular reactive forms. We need to have our own Redux forms as a library you can use and do the form validations and all. What is the difference between set state and force update? When you trigger the set state, it is actually going to ask the should component update for re-rendering the component. But when you do the force update, it is overriding that and it is going to re-render your component 100% every time. It doesn't depend on the should component update. Okay, these are some of the important questions which you may face. Let's connect in the next video.